beautiful creature, Rocky, how could you?
Master!
What?
We have a visitor.
Ship!
Great Scott, Scotty. Dr. Everett Scott. You know this person?
This person?
Of course I do. He's an old friend of mine.
Oh, I see. So this wasn't a chance meeting after all. You came here with a purpose.
Not true. My car broke down. I told you that.
Yes, I know what you told me, Briard. That this Dr. Everett Scott, his name is not unknown to me.
He's a science teacher at Denton High.
Yes, and now he works for your government, doesn't he, Briard? He is attached to the Bureau of Investigation of that which you call UFOs. Oh. Isn't that right, Briard?
He might be. I don't know.
Oh.
Master!
What?
The intruder is entering the building.
Well. We shall make this a social occasion. Riff Raff, see if you can find Janet and Rocky. Magenta, seal off all exits and doors, and bring Dr. Scott to the laboratory! And his female should check the layout for you. Well, I'm afraid there's been a slight change in plans, Dr. Scott. I'm sure that you are adaptable. I know that Brad is.
I can assure you that Brad's presence here comes as a complete surprise to me. As knows your setup, I did not expect to find it quite so,
sophisticated, Dr. Scott?
Yes.
Or should I say Dr. Von Scott?
What exactly are you implying?
Say it in pro-blessing!
Ha!
Aha! That machine's there!
What do you think it is, Doc?
That's its precise moment! It's hard to tell, but it appears to be made of a metal which is not of this earth! In fact, I can say it's from another planet!
Brad!
Janet!
Rocky!
Dr. Scott! Brad!
Janet!
Rocky!
Dr. Scott! Brad!
Janet!
Rocky!
Dr. Scott!
Rocky! Oh, Rocky!
Piss off!
Listen, I made you, and I can break you just as easily, so pull your plug out.
I suppose you intend to do with us, as you did with Eddie?
Eddie? I've seen him. He looks terrible.
What do you know of Eddie, Dr. Scott?
I happen to know a great deal about a lot of things. You see, Eddie happens to be my nephew.
Dr. Scott?
Yes, Brad, my sister's boy. I knew he was in with a bad crowd, but it is worse than I had imagined! Aliens!
Tell him, Doc.
From the day he was born.
Not the night, but the day.
He was trouble.
Not the monopoly, but trouble.
He was the thorn.
Not the rose, but the thorn.
In his mother's side.
Not her ass, but her side.
She cried in vain. Nothing but pain.
That's right, dear.
He left home the day she died. Hide, hide, hide from the day she was born. All he wanted was rock and roll. Born on a motorbike. Shooting up jump.
Where?
He was a low-down, cheap little punk.
Yeah.
Taking everybody for the ride.
Daphne.